Hey everybody, Shawn James here from My Self-Reliance. Welcome back to the cabin. This week I want to answer some questions I've had on the tools that I used to build the cabin. The tool that I'm still using to build the cabin, so I'm not quite finished as you can see. If you click on this video up here, that's something I filmed back in March, I believe it was, when I first started building the cabin on my friend's property. That's all the tools I had acquired for the build, and I had started using those. But now, 6 months later, I now know what I actually use the most of, what I could have eliminated, and what I couldn't do without, and what I really appreciated having. So I'll quickly get into that and make this a short video. First of all, you don't need a really strong, aggressive saw when you're cutting softwood, especially green softwood. So for that, 90% of the cutting that I did was with this little Agawa Canyon folding saw. This is my camping and canoeing saw, and on this I've got the aggressive Sydney Rancher blade. That's actually something you can sharpen. It's very thick. That was more than enough to cut down the trees the size that I was cutting down, along with my axe. Now I have a bigger felling axe you've seen me use on some trees, but for the most part my Gransfer's Bruck forest axe, that bites into softwood. Actually, it was fantastic for limbing the trees, but for most of the cutting, even the felling of the trees, this thing really bites into softwood in particular, and even some of the maples I cut down with this, but it really excelled on the softwood. Played around with a few different saws, including this awesome saw here I thought was going to be really handy for this. I knew at the time when I got it that it was more for hardwood and dry hardwood at that. I actually got it thinking long term for firewood, bucking these maple and oak and yellow birch logs into firewood length. But it's really, really aggressive, right? So nice big heavy saw. Got a handle here so you can run it as a two-man or put it on here for two-handed one person sawing. Really with this dry softwood you only need a fine tooth saw. This thing just way too aggressive. So funny enough, as I was looking around at what saws I already had some old saws like this. It's 26 inches and it's 11 teeth per inch. So it's fairly fine. I hope you can see this. Anyway, very, very fine teeth. Cutting even the slope of the gable ends here, cutting logs off on the ends. Fine tooth saw, a little bit more work, but it did a nice clean cut, straight cut, and not too much effort. Got worse as the project went on because it's hard to sharpen with these little teeth. But like I said, probably my most valuable tool. So that flat chisel that you saw me using all the time, that was also very valuable for getting the notches close to the final shape. And then my wide wood gouge, notching gouge, log notch gouge, that thing was amazing. Just cut through like butter when it was sharp, and I had to continually just drop it. Didn't really have to sharpen it throughout the project, but that did 96, 100 notches, something like that. And then some interior work, so that thing was an awesome tool. This became one of my favorite tools. I've never had one of these before. This is called a slick, actually. It's not a chisel. Looks like a huge, massive chisel. But this butt end here allows you to get it in and do some heavy work, just flattening out things like timber frame notches, or mortises and so on. So you saw me do a lot of that on the timber frame that go across for the second floor to support the second floor. And I also use it actually for flattening out a lot of the higher spots on the log. So I wanted them to fit flat, or there was a ridge or a knot or something like that. This thing was actually better, I found, than a small hewing axe or a hewing hatchet for taking the flat spots off, or the high spots, and flattening those logs out. I used that a lot for that, surprisingly. I didn't expect that. So I ended up really liking using this tool too. I'm looking forward to doing some more timber framing around the property, actually, on some other buildings, because I just really enjoyed that. So it's Chestnut Tools, El Monte, Canada. Picked it up at Lee Valley Tools. Highly, highly recommend that. It's called a slick, like I said, not a chisel. Timber framing slick. So like that tool. Probably wouldn't trade that in. If you made me give it up, I could. There's other things. I could have just used an axe for most of that work, or a chisel. But I liked it. So, what else? Draw knife, debarking the logs and flattening them out. Use two different draw knives. Broke the handle off this one. I'm gonna need to make a new one. and epoxy handle in there. I've had this for a long time. Draw knife is really handy for so many things, for making some doweling, debarking. I've used that tons for debarking, which is how that handle came off, just hitting, jamming up against knots and pulling too hard, broke that handle off. So again, very handy tool. I would highly recommend this for any log cabin build, especially a rustic round log cabin build. So I wouldn't give that up unless you forced me to, and if you did again, I'd go back to the axe. Ripping saw. It's a push saw, but the teeth are fashioned in a way that it rips along the grain instead of across the grain. Cross-cut saw, you go across the grain. Like, picture just a 2x4, let's say, or 1x10 that I've been using for the lumber work in here. Typical saw cross-cuts across that, right? Very smoothly, but try to use that same saw to cut with the grain down the length of a board, and it doesn't go very well. If I had all the time in the world and I was working on a project that I want to do completely on my own with no power tools and didn't want to buy in any lumber and didn't know or have access to a lumber mill of any kind, that's the saw I use, and that's the saw I would continue to use. It's pretty darn good for that kind of work, and you can sharpen it. So, like that saw, not cheap, 100 and something bucks, I think, for that thing, but take care of it, it'll last forever. I've mentioned this axe in the past. I take it on some trips, outdoor trips, tiny little handle on it. It's more like a little carving axe, but see the round bit on that? Not overly functional. It's a little bit difficult to use other than for skinning, and I've used it for that, skinning out a deer and processing a full deer. So I actually find it more useful than that, for that, than anything else. But I did use this for cutting out some of the notches, because it's small, I can get in tight, especially if I was doing something up on the cabin itself. Certainly replaceable. I wouldn't get this as well as the forest axe and a couple other tools. This would be the tool I'd eliminate first. Because I ended up using spikes, 12-inch spikes, to fasten the walls together to stop them from shifting in and out. I had planned on using dowels right from the beginning. I do have hand augers and bit and braces. In the future, I still plan on doing the next cabin or next building that way. But on this project, it would have taken absolutely forever. So I went to those 12-inch spikes, and it really made a solid cabin. This 2 or 3 pound sledge, club hammer, that's also something I've been using for splitting rock, but that was good for starting the spikes. And then I used a full sledgehammer, long handled, and you saw me up on the walls even swinging that thing. So that drove in the spikes. So again, not a very exciting tool, but functional because I used nails. You know, if you want to use just natural materials, you just use wood dowels. So of course, the other thing, because I'm doing that type of work, just the standard, this is a 20-ounce S-twing hammer. I used it for doing sheet metal work for years. I've had this for like 25 years. Not the prettiest, not the most traditional looking, but man, is it worth the money as it lasts. So you see this in almost every single video. You see me carrying the timbers and the logs with that little red log carrier. Carrying the logs around with that just saved me having to either carry the logs up against my body, scratching my side, and putting a lot of pressure on my forearm and my wrist. I found just walking with that thing saved my back, saved my arms. If I had to choose just 6 tools to do the cabin with, okay, since it's in my hand, hammer, axe, I'm gonna say that log gouge, little red log carrier. I'm gonna have to say a sledgehammer because of the nail. That's the tools, that's my list. Throw in a bunch of stuff on top of that, safety glasses, gloves. You're gonna wear a couple pair of leather gloves. Ripping saw to make boards, lumber. You have to have a sharpening stone. That just goes with everything. All hand tools always have to have a strop and sharpening stone. I think that is it. Then you're gonna have ladders and stuff, but bottom line is you can get away with fairly minimal number of tools, and you can use some of those tools for any of your other general woodworking projects and bush projects. So worthwhile having them. Of course, if you're going to go power, you're going to get a chainsaw and a few other things, but to me, I would just prefer to stick with the hand tools and just enjoy those and be able to use those anywhere without having to go get fuel, pay for fuel, maintain those tools, and so on. A lot easier to maintain those hand tools. Hope that wasn't too long-winded. Hope that helped out the guys that are asking the questions about my tools. If you have any specific questions on make and model and where to get them and things like that, again, just comment below and I'll answer you as quickly as I can. Callie, can I have my leather glove back, please? Come here, girl. Callie, come here. Come here. Come here. Good girl. Come and sit. All right, so that's it. Thanks for watching this one. Look forward to seeing you up the cabin again next week. Take care. Have a great week.